much. Too much.
There's too much dry shampoo.
You make a really sexy older woman, though.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Toots, give me some of that.
Go. Are you cold?
Are you taking a video?
I think so.
Oh no.
Hey, turn around. Let's get that side view of the tucked in here. I love that look.
Bonsoir, c'est moi, Natasha, et je suis en France, and I am taking over Participant Media's Instagram story, sharing my hashtag stories of pride. So make sure you hop over there and watch their Instagram stories before I fall into a cheese coma. I'm Natasha Negovanlis, and I am a Canadian actress and creator, best known for playing a broody lesbian vampire in the digital series turned feature film called Carmilla. And as a creator, I recently co-created, co-produced, and co-wrote a digital series called Clairvoyant about two girls and best friends who pretend to be psychics to pay their rent until my character Claire, an openly queer woman, finds out that she's actually psychic and adventures ensue. Normally, I am Toronto or sometimes LA-based, but hello, greetings from the south of France. That's right, I am in France, but I still wanted to contribute to this story and share my stories of pride. Why? Well, I'm so glad you asked. I am a proudly out actress. That's right. I identify as queer, or you can call me pansexual. And no, that doesn't mean I'm sexually attracted to pots and pans. Although sometimes I'm like a little fry curious. That was a bad pun. So what that means is that I hate everyone equally. No, I'm totally just kidding. It means that I love people regardless of their gender identity. Because I identify as pansexual, it's really important to me that we start to have more content and entertainment that has realistic representation of pansexual or bisexual women. We ain't all homewreckers. I'm also really interested in seeing more content and entertainment where being queer is just normalized, where it's not at the forefront of the story. I mean, yes, there is a time and a place for coming out stories, but it doesn't all have to be doom and gloom. That's why I feel so grateful to have been a part of the projects that I've acted in or created, because they're just entertaining stories. And so what? Some of the characters happen to be queer. They happen to land on the spectrum. They happen to be trans. They happen to be non-binary. And it doesn't make up the entire plot line of these projects. So the more we provide positive LGBTQIA2++ representation like this, the more we are telling folks that they are worthy and valid and deserving of happiness. Because they are, because we all are. And my hope is that by sharing LGBTQ stories, we can also convince some straight folks who are maybe not allies yet that we're all just human beings and we have a lot more in common than you think. Surprise, we all poop, no matter who we're getting into bed with. Well, hopefully not while we're getting into bed with people. Unless that's your thing, because like, no shame, whatever you're into, no shame. Okay, and rant. Thank you so much for listening. I gotta go now because there is a brick of French cheese with my name on it. But thank you so much for listening to my stories of pride. If you are watching this because you are one of my fans or followers, then make sure you follow Participant and check out all of their incredible films. I myself in particular am super, super stoked to see RBG. Can't wait. What a boss lady. And if you are like, who the hell is this girl? Then once more, my name is Natasha Negovanlis, long scary Greek last name. Don't worry, when you type it into Google, it'll probably autocorrect it for you. Or you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at NatVanlis. Thanks and bye. Her perfect, she don't understand. She's worth it. All that beauty goes deeper than the surface. Oh, oh. So to all the girls that's hurting, let me be your mirror. Help you see a little bit clearer. The light that shines within. There's a hope that's waiting for you.
Hold on and just wait until you can get out of that bubble, because the things that seem like weaknesses, that seem like weird things that make you strange, when you become an adult, you get out into the world, you're gonna find out that all those differences, they're like your greatest strengths.